It is apparent that some in attendance heard or thought they overheard an inappropriate word, and in lieu of reporting the incident in accordance with our newly adopted harassment policy, chose to instead contact a member of the media, thus igniting the firestorm that brings us all here tonight.
And that is Harford and Cecil County Delegate Mary Ann Lisanti from her news conference last night after the House of Delegates voted to censure her. Robert Lang in the WBAL News Center, along with C4.
And they also didn't allow her to speak.
And they didn't. And that was part of her floor speech that she gave to a group of reporters, including WBAL's David Collins last night, just outside the House chamber. What do we make of this?
Well, I tell you, Robert, and I'm consistent with this, I do not believe that what she has done, which she's acknowledged, that she, even though she equivocated a little bit in the statement that you played, that she should be removed from office or have to resign. I don't believe that. However, having her, not only her leadership taken away, but she's no longer a member of the Economic Matters Committee the House of Delegates, that in essence, she has been removed as a delegate.
Now,
the only
thing she
can do is go to the floor.
She can go to the floor. She can also go to committees to lobby before her own bills.
But who is effectively is going to listen to somebody who has no vote in committee? She has been effectively neutered in terms of serving her constituents. So on the basis of that, I think that she should resign and let somebody come in who can effectively be a delegate, because they're not going to give her these powers back, even if she goes through sensitivity training, or even if she does some of the things, Robert, they've suggested.
There was an announcement at the end of the Senate session today from Republican George Edwards that the Joint Legislative and Ethics Committee would meet. Now, this functions as kind of a grand jury for lawmakers recommending the penalties, including removal.
Right.
Famously, Senator Ulysses Curry, after his federal case was there and that recommended a censure for him. I believe he was the last senator to be censured. Senator Larry Young was expelled back 20 years ago.
Yes.
But realistically, now they operate in secret, so they never confirm or deny the existence unless they come after you. Realistically, could they even do anything for Delegate Lisanti regarding
that? The only
that?
Thing more powerful than censuring is expulsion. I mean, that is the second worst thing you can do to a legislator. So they could, using your examples you gave, go to expulsion. I don't think it's warranted, considering we're not talking about a crime or anything that she has been charged with. I'm just saying, Robert, that right now, I thought that if she went through sensitivity training and if she went through all these hoops, that maybe she might get her voting privileges, committee. But she's not. Apparently, the call from the speaker is to resign. The call from 130 unanimous vote of her members is to resign. She cannot serve the constituents of Harford and Cecil County anymore now. So I think she should leave to allow somebody to be able to fulfill that function.
And to her comments that you heard at the beginning of the segment that they told the Washington Post rather than reported it to the House Speaker.
Right.
And this is a reference, we believe, according to the Washington Post, to Delegate Jay Walker.
Because his, the 26th district, that's where the colleague was campaigning. Look, where I am, Robert, in all of this is I truly believe that we have lost, when I say we collectively, this country, has lost the ability, as Eric Holder said, to have an intelligent discussion about race. We immediately want to crucify, get rid of individuals instead of sitting the delegate down and having an intelligent discussion about where we go on the issue of sensitivity and race. So if that's the standard we're going by, let's see how this plays out with others.
C4 show back Monday 9 to 1 on
WBAL
News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.